Hey everybody, Davey here from Davey's World Fishing. Today I'm going to give you a little one-year review of the Riot Mako 12 kayak. It's an awesome pedal kayak, very budget-minded, but there's some great pros and cons that you need to be aware of, and I'm going to show you some of the simple modifications that I made that's going to make your life a little bit easier. Now for the past year, the Mako 12 kayak has been a great kayak for me. As I mentioned, it's a budget kayak. They come in at about $1,500. For a propeller drive, pedal drive system. That's a very good deal out in the kayak market. Like I said, there's a couple pros, there's a couple cons. The pros, of course, being the price. As I said, $1,500 for a pedal kayak is a great deal compared to some that are up in the thousands up there. But as some people say, you kind of get what you pay for. It's been a great kayak, it still is, and I continue to fish it, and I plan on continuing fishing it because it's been an awesome little boat. They do offer the impulse drive here, which is their pedal system. If you watch my other video, I'll link that up above. I give you the full rundown. So one of the first cons I came across, or the first issues I had, was this little plastic guard system. So you can see there's a clear plastic guard here that attaches right to the pedal drive, and it goes right on down through the hole there. The issue I had that is if you don't line that thing up and put it in real straight and exact, this plastic will actually crack. You don't want the thing to crack, and mine did. You can see a crack here, and it actually ran all the way up through the screws. So all I did, black duct tape solves the world, right? All the problems. So I wrapped that thing in black duct tape. It's been good since. It holds the screws and everything in place. I haven't had any further issues, and it hasn't cracked any further. I'm sure something like a Flex Seal or any of those other things would do just as well for you. That was kind of the first issue I had. Not a big deal. I thought it was going to be a little detrimental there at the beginning, but it wasn't. What that clear plastic does is when it's down in this hole and you're pedaling, the water actually gurgles and spits up through here and it gets water everywhere. That actually just keeps the spitting of the water from shooting up at you. As I said, not detrimental to the kayak. If you didn't have that, it would just be probably a little wetter ride. But you know, that little clear system, you can also look down there. See if your propeller's fouled up. See if you have any kelp or eelgrass or fishing line or anything that happens to be caught up in your propeller, you know, making it difficult to pedal or even to get it back up. But that's what that's for. First issue I had was that cracking there. Second issue, and this is just because I'm a big dude, but the material on the seat, very comfortable seat, but it actually started to rip right away too. I think it was the first trip out that it ripped. That's as far as the rip has gone. I'm going to say that's probably, 2.5-3 inches. That's the only issue on the seat that I've had. The strap buckles, like that, if you can see, I just push that thing open, it actually stays open. The spring on that, not very strong. The other one's fine, this particular one, not. So if you're putting your seat down, put it on top of your car, a lot of times it'll stay open, the straps will go wild, but you know, that's definitely not an issue at all. You can see a little bit of some corrosion building up there as well. Now the big issue I had was the steering system. The steering system, for those of you that have a Mako 12, and a lot of the kayaks are very similar to that, is that it was very stiff. It took a lot of force to turn. You get back here, it takes a lot of force to turn this way. There was a lot of resistance in that steering system. You know, that could be, you know, it's steered. That was great. But what happens there is when you put that much force and that much bend into this line, there's steel cables that come through here, and it wraps around this side, wraps around this side. Is that when it takes that much force and there's that much resistance, you can have run the risk of actually snapping that cable. That cable runs down through the seat, it goes right in through the back there, it runs down the kayak, up through the back here, and originally it would come up the side here. I'm gonna show you my modification here in just a minute. I've actually snapped three cables on this kayak, three steering cables. I've been either out to sea, I've been way out in Long Beach Harbor where I'm about 3 to 4 miles from the launch. I've been up at a couple different lakes where I'm also very far. So not having steering on a pedal drive system can be dangerous. You watch my other video for some safety tips on having a paddle with you if your steering does go out. You're able to use that paddle as a rudder system, which I was able to do and get back safely. No issues there. Now with the broken rudder system and cables, the company Mako Riot Kayaks, Kayak Distribution is actually the parent company. They've been great at getting me out a new unit. I took it down to Oceanside. I happen to be in California. That's where the distributor is. They were very helpful in getting it changed out. Eric at the shop there switched it out for me. Took about an hour. He also sent me home with an extra one, which was great. It snapped about 2 weeks later and I was able to replace it myself. Then my third one actually lasted probably about 2 months, and then it snapped. So, you know, doing a lot of digging in this and wondering why these cables are snapping, and I've done a few different, looked at some different reviews and some videos, and I've seen this situation pop up. The company seems to be somewhat aware of it. I know they're working out some different steering systems for their kayaks. As I mentioned, this happens in other kayaks as well because everybody uses a very similar system. So one thing I noticed was there was a big bend right out of the little box here. There was a big bend that created quite a bit of friction as it either went under the seat or over, depending on where you have it. A lot of people will put this whole system behind here. Then you have a kind of a bend that goes directly to the seat. You can put it in front. Just depends on where you like your seat. I'm not tall. I'm just about 6 feet tall, so my seat's not all the way back. It's not forward very far. I like my legs a little bit straighter when I'm pedaling. I still keep that bend in the knee like you're supposed to. So but I'm just pointing out the fact that I don't have it all the way back and I don't have it all the way forward. So I like it actually in front of the seat system here. So what I do is what I found out then was as I'd run this through here and as I'm turning, it's like feels great resistance. Very hard to steer. It took a while to get it back. Sometimes it would pop. You get it over here, it would pop just to get it to steer. So when you come towards the back of the boat here, originally, those steering cables came out right here. They'd come out here and they'd come out a direct, they'd come out and up. There was a little pin system that would actually hold it down, and then that would lead down to here. That led down to your steering. So that big bend, and it was a really sharp turn that created a lot of resistance. And then the cables that they were using were actually a rubber coated or a silicone coated wiring, and that created some friction within the plastic tubing as well. So it slowed it down. It made it very hard to steer left and right. So that was the main thing I found. So your cables came up, as you can see down in the hatch here. You can kind of see the cables down there. So what happens is they'll come up. They came up through these holes, very sharp turn, and then they went down. So that big arc right there was a very good resistance point for that rudder system and those rudder cables. Now, the modification I did, I looked online and I talked to a couple different people, and someone suggested using a bicycle cable. So I did that. I purchased some bicycle cables, and it has worked out good so far. Now, the bicycle cables I found were on Amazon. I think there's 10 sets of cables, and it was about $8. Made in China. You can see there's the model number there. I'll actually put a link to this in my in the description down below as well. But there's two different lengths in here. I want to say there's a 6 foot or 8 foot, and then a shorter one as well. Like I said, these are for bicycles, so they don't have to have quite the great distance that we have on kayaks. But it was actually a very simple switch. I'm glad I found that online. It actually worked out well for me. And then I'll show you. I'll kind of just kind of walk you through it. I'm not going to take it apart, but I'll walk you through what I did, and I'll show you the modification I made at that other end there. So when I would open this up, when I'm out steering, and all of a sudden you feel bam, and this thing breaks loose sideways, you know that cable snapped. You no longer have steering. Sometimes your rudder's stuck in one side, either left or right, and then you're paddling in circles. Of course, you pull your thing, your rudder's going to pop back up, and then you don't have to worry about it. If you got the paddle with you, very simple. Just use that as a rudder. So anyway, you open up your whole steering box here, you disassemble it, you take it off, open it up, and you can find that broken steering cable. And I can see that it was right at the end here. There was so much resistance that it was putting a lot of bend into this cable, because this cable on this left side here, on this far one, actually comes up and it makes a sharp turn up here. So when you put a lot of resistance to make that thing turn, that's where you were getting that real resistance point. That actually started way back in the back there, because that's where all that resistance was. So anyway, it would snap. So what I would do, or what I did, is I'd come back here. At the time, my cable was still coming up at that sharp bend. I'd disassemble it, take it off, walk back here, and then I would pull that cable out. Just pull those broken cables out. I went ahead and took my new cable, and I fed them on through both sides. They're very easy to lock in here, but you feed your new cables in. And then what I noticed, because I left it the way it was, is that as it came up through here, I was still getting resistance. Now, this was the big resistance point. Those are non-coated cables, so there's no plastic coating on them or silicone coating, but they're corrosion resistant, so they should be good. I do a lot of saltwater fishing. They slid right through the cable, which was very easy, very nice, until it got to this point. Now, this was the big issue that I talked about earlier. was that it came from a steep angle, went up, and then went right back down. So it was a sharp turn. And when I put it through there, I could feel it. That's where the thing would slow down coming up and through there. It wasn't free, wasn't straight by any means. And then as I put them through and I kind of had them up there, I realized as I'm still turning, I was like, man, I still got a lot of resistance. It's freer than it was, but there's still a lot of resistance. So the video I saw online said what he did was, you know, try to get the straightest angle as possible. So in thinking about that, what I did was I took the drill, I went down here, and I went just about even with it. You can see there's a little bit of angle there, but it goes just about even with the rudder cable there. Drilled two holes, I pulled this cabling out, I ran it through the other side, and popped it right out here. Once it came out here, now it's got a direct line. It goes straight in, straight into that cable, down all the way to the rudder system. Did that on both sides. Very simple. You lock them in, you got your little pin system here. It's still nice and loose. You don't want to screw those down tight, otherwise you're going to create a very sharp bend in your cables as well. Put a little silicone, waterproof silicone on there, sealant. Clean as I probably could have done that a little bit better, but got those nice and sealed up. Did it on both sides. But as you can see, it's almost a straight across there. I probably could have went just a little bit straighter. But what's really cool now, once you get that going, is you've got zero resistance now. You can see the thing turning. You got zero resistance. You got just about full, actually probably even a little bit more left to right than it had originally. But like I said, zero resistance. Very nice. Made it nice and easy. You can, you know, you don't have to get the full grip on this thing to really try to get that turn anymore, but nice and easy when you're on the water. It's been a cool little fix so far. Very excited about that. But anyway, that's kind of the 1 year run through as well as my rudder fix on the Mako 12. If you're having that issue out there, I would take a look at something like that. But so far, that change to that rudder system has been awesome. I hope that works for you. Like I said, it's very easy to turn now, very easy to steer. That was really the one big bugaboo. Of course, I said I went through three cables in a year, which is a lot. They've got a fresh one coming out, but I did this fix, and this seems to be actually really working well so far, so I might just keep running with this. But I do appreciate y'all checking in. Don't get stuck on the water. I hope that works. Do appreciate y'all checking in. Do me a favor, hit that like button down below and subscribe to Davey's World Fishing up in that right-hand corner. And we'll see you out on the water.